Now then, YouTube, I'm the Tough Man, and welcome back to some more York City. No, it's not York City at all, it's Leicester City Simulated Manager Mode playthrough. I'm so used to saying that, guys. I have 200 parts of that now, so yeah, it's kind of stuck in there. No, we are on Leicester City and we're on part 9. We are currently looking for people to buy. As always, guys, this is the thing that people are most interested about. So I've decided that my left back can do with it, because we've got this dude Segley, or whatever his name is, who can cover at left back as well if we need him to. However, I'm going to get free agent Petr Zanev, who I showed you in the last one, just as cover for this season, and probably this season only. Let's approach to sign him. $3,000. Squad rotation. It's probably going to whinge at me saying, "Oh, fucking hell." But it's tough. So squad rotation, that's $3,000 on that guy. I'm going to get Jose Cavallo as a goalkeeper here. And that's another $3,000. He is going to be squad rotation. Well, he's more like a sporadic first team, but I'm just going to say that is that. That for 3 years, $3,000. That's another $3,000 gone. We should be okay for wages. For this last person, Glem. 3,500, 20,000 wage, but I'm 3,500, 3.5 million. But I'm hoping that we can get this guy for a little bit cheaper. It doesn't look like we can, actually, which is a damn shame. I'm going to go in with the first offer of £4 million, see what they say, and we'll take it from there. I will stall the offers for the other guys if I can. But they are the people I want to buy, and we'll go into more detail on them if I get them, because there's no point going into loads of detail if I'm not actually going to buy the players. And I did actually put Nugent on the transfer list, because I believe for 2.7 million I can get some money in, and I could even get a better player than Guilherme. So it all depends on if somebody wants Nugent to whether or not I buy Guilherme. I know I've put her in an offer for him, but I can always stall that, whatever. 4.3 million pounds for Guilherme. I'm going to put in 4.3. I mean, why not? I can afford it. 600 grand after that. So I could take 600 grand off the thing. Now, he's a 77 rated striker, whereas Nugent's obviously a 75. Guilherme is 24. Nugent is 28. So it just makes it a lot easier. It makes it a lot better that I'm replacing him for somebody a lot better. So I'm going to advance the situation, see if anybody does want that guy. I've also put Futach up for sale as well. He's accepted the contract offer of 3,000. So let's accept him. Good stuff. He's quite all right with being a squad rotation. That's good for me. He's declined it. And to be honest, I'm not fucking giving him any more money than that, so he can get stuffed. Right, team management. I don't really need to do team management, do I? Well, yeah, I do, because Konchesky should be there. And Zanev is there as backup. Left back is going to be top of my priorities next season / January / whenever it is that I've got some money. Cashmish Michael's injured. So we're going to end up with Smith in goal. That was why I wanted a new goalkeeper. I remember now. Of course it is. Right, see what happens. See if anybody wants Nugent. Adam Smith! Sorry, I can't. There's no point. I might as well just reject it anyway. There's no point in accepting it. It would never go. I'm not quite sure how long left Konchesky's got on his injured. It's been accepted at £4.3 million. 20k wages, length of 3 years. He will be a crucial team player. We'll leave it at that. Now, I will need to go Real Madrid in bail talks. What a surprise. Now, I will need to go into transfers, budget allocation, and shove 600 grand in there. So it was 4.3. Look at that, loads of dosh. 4.3. There we are. accept that allocation. Right, let me go into buy players. I really do need that goalkeeper. Not that one particular goalkeeper. Might as well just go for that goalkeeper. I've got some more money now, haven't I? So, transfer negotiations. Negotiations. Cavallo, there he is. Submit new offer for him then. 4,000. Squad rotation. See if he accepts that. Need to see if Willem bloody accepts his. Now, what would throw a spanner in the works? He has declined it again. Look, bigger role in the squad he wants. Well, he's not going to get a bigger role in the squad, is he? So I'm going to have a look. Let's reset that. See if there is a free agent goalkeeper. There's a guy who's a similar age there, Badra Alisangare. May as well give him a crack. See about age, actually. Yeah, no, that's fine. That's fine. It's absolutely fine. He's looking for a new club. Well, you'll be a squad rotation player, whether you like it or not. So whether or not you want to come to us is totally up to you. And some people have been telling me, if you buy scouts, apparently, you know, they do summit or whatever it is during the season. And when it comes around to going getting free transfers and stuff, you'll get more people there or something. Don't make sense to me, but it's something I will look into. Once I've bought everybody, once I've got all my stuff sorted, I will then go and get my scouts, guys. How's that for you? I will go and get the scouts after that. I've got Everton coming up. First game of the season. Still nothing from Guilherme either. He's accepted it. So we've got a new guy. Look at that, we've got hardly any blue money left. We've just got wage. 15 grand wage. New signing arrived. We can partner him actually with. Whoa, why have I got like. Oh, I'm going to say, why is it 3-4-3-3 here? But Nugent should be there. Wood would normally be there, but Wood would obviously make way for Guilherme. You need to make way for what's his first? Segler. I think that's it. I think we'll leave it as that. Entertain Wolverhampton Wanderers. Hull City host Nottingham Forest. So Leicester City entertain Morecambe. There's no point in selling that guy, Nugent. Where are you, Nugent? There you are. There's no point in selling you. I'm going to remove you from the transfer list. We may as well keep you for the rest of this season. Contract offer has been accepted. Great. Got our backup guy in. Thank fuck, because we're going to go in against Everton with 48 rated goalkeeper. Wow. What edge is that? Sangare there. Okay, let's get the centre backs up there. Don't need three forwards, that's for sure. Could do with either a left or right mid. There we are. Look. Michael's still injured. No, actually, we need to take one of these out. James, you're out, fella. Just put you there. You there. Look at that. Great stuff. Just put you in there for him. That's looking good. It's looking okay. I mean, it's not particularly brilliant, guys. I'm going to go out there and say it's not particularly brilliant. But still, we just hope that given the simulation of this, that they get, you know, my players do get a lot better than they currently are. Or at least I hope so. First game against Everton. Are we at home or away? We've got international management at Finland, which I'm not particularly bothered about. There's going to be none of that in this playthrough. Willem expected to make debut. Yes, he is. But not before I go to team management over here. Squad. Switch everybody around to see if everybody's okay. And see what comes up. So De Seglu's been put at left back anyway. Dyer's been put at left mid. Not too bad. Not too bad. I'll take it. Distegler can play there. Distegler can play there. Simulate the match. We're away at Everton on the first game of the season. I'm thinking that my ass, it might be handed to me on a plate here. 1-0, that's not too bad. It's not too bad. They did miss a penalty. They must have scored pretty early on. But 1-0 is not too bad. It's still a loss, guys, and I've still got no points for it. But 1-0 is not a bad result against Premier League opposition. And, you know, top-end Premier League opposition as well. Bolton Wanderers 1, Swansea City. I just need my goalkeeper back. I want, what's his Kasper Schmeichel back? Liverpool 3, Cardiff City. Liverpool top of the table. There he is. He's been cleared, but he'll have a plaster on, so there's no point in getting him yet. Tottenham Hotspur 1. Handed in a transfer. I don't give a shit. Get rid of him. West Bromwich Albion. I'm not poised for Finland's manager role at all. Don't know where you got that from. That reminds me. Have I bought everybody now? I think I bought everybody, haven't I? Yeah, I have. I've bought everybody that I want to buy, currently. Now, where is it? Budget allocation. So you can see, we've not got much fucking dosh left, guys. 12,000 wage budget. Let's take off that wage budget and put on transfer budget, because I think we need the transfer budget for the scouts, if I remember right. So, let me go to my manager's office. Youth Academy Scouting Network. And let's see who we can hire for the measly amount that we've got. Jason Forster Kaske. I could get loads of shit ones. Could get three crap ones or one mediocre one. I think I'll just get three crap ones, you know. Yep. And... yep. Yes, I do want to... thank you. They're in transit. They've been boxed up on the way. Look, you're in transit. What the fuck? As if you'd say that. They've been boxed up, put in the back of the wagon, and they're on the way to me, my new brand new scouts. Arrived. Arrived. And arrived. So let's get in there and get those guys just wandering around. Manager's office, youth academy, scouting network. Set up a scouting network. In third place, Arsenal entertain 5th place Wigan Athletic. Send to England. 4th place Norwich City visit 20th place Fulham. 9 months. Send him to England all season. Any type of player. We'll send him to his own place. So we're not using like tons and tons of money here. I want to do so. I do want to send somebody over to Brazil, of course. Whoa, cancel. What? Can I actually scout South America? The entire lot of South America? Oh no, because it does come up as Argentina, whether I like it or not. Brazil, of course. And I'm off there for 9 months. That's going to be 142,000. Any type of player, be fine with me. And set up a scouting network. The Germans. There's the Germans. There he is. Central Europe. I'll send him to Germany, actually. It'd be a good idea. And any type of player. I don't care. Just come up with somebody. See what I think. And we'll carry on from there. Liverpool next. Brilliant. What an amazing start to the season. We've got two really hard games, one after another. Both the Merseyside teams. Yeah, I get you doing that. You're thinking of playing St. Gary instead of me, boss? Yes, I am. Because you've got a plaster on your face. Look, you've got a plaster on you. You don't play with a plaster on. So, it's a bit tough, isn't it? Next match. Whoa. I need to do this squad management and all that shit. Well, my guy needs to do it. Let's get them put on. See who it comes up with. Zavala, drink water. Oh, that is a nice midfield, that. That's a real nice midfield. Nugent. Can Nugent actually play as left mid? Seriously. He can. He's a striker slash left mid. So we've got Wood and Guilherme. I think that's not a bad title. Not a bad side, that. But I don't think it's a, you know, a Liverpool crushing side. But you never know. Stranger things have happened. simulator guy at this game. We are at home as well. Suarez, Gerrard, Sterling. Who have they actually bought? Nobody. They bought absolutely nobody. And 1-0. 80th minute. Another 1-0 loss means that we're probably rooted to the bottom still. No, we shouldn't be rooted to the bottom, actually, because I reckon other teams would be, you know, a lot worse off that have lost twice by more than just two goals. So, yeah, we're second to bottom. Not usually one to blow my own trumpet, but I think I would have made an impact. Well, you've got a plaster on, guy. So get your plaster off, get yourself sorted, and then you can play. It's fine. Becchio, second to top scorer there. Marco Fucic. Finally, we've got an offer for him. Of what he's worth. So that's good. Let's submit the offer. I'll take that. And then Aston Villa on transfer deadline day. Now, this is a bit dodgy, guys, because playing games on transfer deadline day. Deal to sell to Bolton has been finalised. 450 grand for me. Playing games on deadline day. Is that when it skips them, or is it the day after deadline day it skips them for you? I'm sure it's on deadline day where it skips the fucking game and you can't do anything about it. Transfer offer for Adam Smith. They're still trying to buy him. You'll never get rid of him. I can accept it as much as I like, but you never buy him. What's that cup? That Capital One Cup, okay. It's the Capital One Cup, guys. First, we've got a dispatch of Aston Villa, which I'm quietly confident of. Not. I don't think that we're going to do well. They said a predictive finish of 9th, and I'm laughing my fucking ass off, thinking, what is you actually on about? What a surprise, transfer talks have been broken down. Real Madrid accept £30 million bid from Manchester City. Holy fuck. In fact, I could go to the manager's office. Go to contracts. No, not contracts, is it? It's transfers, sell players. Smith, stacking up 1,500 wage. I could just release him from his contract. Go on, fuck off. Get out of here. Now I've got some more wage to play with. Not that I can buy anybody like, but I could do if I wanted to. I could do. I'll have a look on free transfer, see if there's anybody left floating around. You never know. So, let me transfers. I'll need all the wage budget I can get for free transfers. 18,000, I'll do. And buy players. Free agents is already there. Whoops. Let's go with that. See who's there. Just to have a gander. And if they're all shit, then I'm not going to bother. Quite obviously. 69 rated. Nobody really to write home about, I suppose. 23-year-old Gabe Valverde. Nobody, you know, young who's rated around there that could possibly make over 70. So that's not going to be happening anytime soon. Squad. Switch this around. Hopefully Schmeichel's back in goal. No, apparently not. He's still got his plaster on. So other than that, not looking too bad. Come on now. Let's get our first win of the season here. Against Aston Villa, away from home. Fuck's sake. I got owned by Aston Villa there. Probably bottom of the island. Oh, that's actually quite good for me. I would, if that was me personally, if I was just playing around with, you know, off YouTube, I'd probably accept that, to be honest, because I like Ireland. I am part Irish, about dad's side. Chelsea. Transfer one. Deadline day. Bolton Wanderers 1. Manchester United. Michael disappointed two. With Tough. Well, you got a plaster one. On. Norwich City. Fuck's two. Sake. The Sports game really needs one. To code that in. City and one. You know, the reason why you're not playing is one. Because you're still Sunderland you know, two. You've got your knock. City. And I'm not risking you. West Bromwich Albion, nil. So, you Arsenal, know, you just have to wait. Chelsea Should be disappointed with me for that. Calendar. And let's take a look at what those results. Yes, I'm sure. I'm not just pressing A for the funnies. Ozturk, 1.6 mil. It's not bad. 1.8 million. That's because I didn't actually look at anything that was going on. Okay. Ireland snubbed by Toth. That's right. International duties coming up. I'll do this this game and then call it at the end of the episode there. Now I've started the season. We might actually get a win here. Our first win ever. I knew... See, this is the thing with going up the first season with Leicester. Is trying to stay up. Hey, Kasper Schmeichel's playing. He's got his plaster off. Oxford United entertain Liverpool. Here we go. Morecambe. We're actually against the people who want to buy that fucking goalkeeper. Here, have him now. You can have him. I'd give you him for free, but it just won't go to you. 3-1. Nugent scoring two goals. De Segli scoring one goal. Blythe getting injured, but he's not a regular scorer, so I don't really care. A regular player, should I say. And he's only got a 3-day injury, so it's not too bad. So there we are, guys. Real bad start to the Premier League. We are bottom of the league. We're the only team who haven't actually got any points at all. And I can't say, you know, that it's not unexpected. It is expected. And I'm hoping that I don't get sacked. I really am hoping that I don't get sacked. But we'll see. We will see what happens as we're going along. I'm hoping that we hold on and just, you know, keep up. I want to keep up in this league. I can't believe that they said that they expected me to finish ninth. It's just ridiculous. But we'll see how it goes. Until next time, I've been the Tough Man, as always. Stay safe.